It's a John Deere 6520 on the rake today, on a 57 plate with a Krone 2 rotor rake. So that's another field nearly finished with the rake anyway. Now that'll probably be the next field in the background there. Now I think some of the people that do the raking leave their window open so they can hear what's happening if they lose a tine or such like. There he goes. Anyway, that's the end rigs off now, so things should just a case of going up and down now. It's a 6930, that one. So far it's been a John Deere fleet. All the tractors are John Deere, and obviously the forage harvesters are John Deere as well. So I'll go back into the pit and see what's I expect it'll be a John Deere that's actually working in the pit as well, but time will tell. I don't expect I'll get to the end, just I hope not, and I might have to move. I think I might have to move. As I said earlier on, it's a 7480 on a 14 plate. But it's always nice to get something new, another contractor. Just while I'm waiting for the forage harvester to start off again, some cattle in the background there, black and brown. And away we go again. It's quite a row of grass, probably 30 feet and a swath. So I expect it's Kenny Spence who's actually on the forage harvester himself. Never met the guy. You always think they won't get to the end, but you will. Looking out for a tractor with a seat to go back to the farm. That's another load away. It's not looking very promising weather wise, but might be lucky. And there's always room for some more, isn't there? That's him got to the other end there. I'll get some of the hills in the background here. You can actually see the mist at the top of the hill there. It's not too bad a day to film, to be honest. I can use my screen rather than my viewfinder.